My name's Tamas Keefer, I'm 20 years old, and I'm into skateboard photography. Well, I think I was in about year six when I got into skateboarding. My neighbors actually had a board and I would be nagging and nagging mum. I was like, I need to get a skateboard. I really, really need to get a skateboard. And just so happens we went on a family trip to the Sunshine Coast and my uncle's a uni lecturer and someone had left a skateboard at the back of one of his classes. And he said, oh, come outside. And he gave me the skateboard. That's kind of how I got into skateboarding. It was just kind of pretty much luck, I guess, which is pretty crazy. And then through photography, it was kind of a couple of things. It kind of all at the same time led to, a couple of things pointed me in that direction. Like my friend gave me a DVD for my birthday and in one of the bonus features, it had Ed Templeton talking about these zines that he did and some photos that he'd shot. I'm like, oh, one day I want to do that. I want to make a book of photos. So most Sundays we all go out. We generally will either we'll find a place to meet up. Usually it's like either Varsity or the shop, or depending on where we're going and who's coming out. It's pretty chill. Like some days are more productive than others. Some days you're like, all right, we're going to this spot. And other days we're just like, stuff it. Let's just go skate to cruise and do whatever. One of them will film and then I'll shoot photos and it's really chill, man. Like real cruisy.
Yeah.
I think it was probably about 2 years or so ago, and I was shooting photos and nothing was really like, I hadn't got anything published, I don't think, at that point or anything like that. One day Julian messaged me, he said, hey man, like really like your photos, we're starting up this shop, would really love for you to be a part of that. And at the time it was pretty crazy because I looked up to these guys, I was like, whoa, like Julian Lee's messaging me, like what the hell, this is so weird. And it's funny now looking back because I'm like, oh, he's just my friend. Like, he's literally just the nicest dude ever. But I was like, whoa, this is crazy. And then later on, they started getting like some ads printed up in like some small magazines and stuff like that. So they needed photos for it. So I guess I was out and I'd shoot things for them. And with the Converse ad out the front of the shop, it was kind of the guys that always wanted to have one of the team riders out the front of the shop and someone local and not just some professional skateboarder from the States. They wanted some kind of something local. I literally heard and they're like, yeah, we need a photo for it. So we went out and shot this one trick and I was trying really hard, but it just wasn't working out. And then so I was like freaking out, like I've blown it. And then I was like, is there any more spots? Is there any other things you can think of? It's like, yeah, actually I've got this spot. It's like a wall ride. Anyway, so we went there and I just set up straight away, super easy, like no lights or anything like that. The sun was perfect, so shot a photo, kept asking, like, oh, are we going to hear back soon or anything like that? And then I'd kind of forgotten about it. I'd gone, oh, well, I guess it's not going to happen. Like, that's a cool idea, but it probably won't happen. And then I literally just got a message from Trent, the owner, and it was just a picture of the front display. I have to get there. Like, I literally quickly got changed and just drove out just to see it. I don't think I'll maybe ever get a photo blown up that big again. You never know. But it was such a crazy feeling just to have your photo that size and out the front of such a, you know, I'm super stoked to have it out the front of such a cool shop. I'm definitely more drawn to black and white. Like, there's something about black and white when I shoot that overcut. Well, oh, look, it's hard. It depends on the photo. But I'm generally more drawn to a black and white picture. For me, I shoot it a lot. I am a little bit colorblind, so I do struggle with editing some colors. So maybe that's why, I don't know. But usually it's pretty sweet. Like, I just play around with some stuff. And I think, again, like that's kind of good because you don't want your photo to look exactly like real life. You want it to be different. And, you know, maybe if my colors are a little bit off to someone else, then maybe that's, I don't know, might be a point of difference, not better, not worse, but just different. So one of the photos I'm most proud of is definitely one I get hit up all the time. It's my friend Jesse and he's doing a trick in Chugan Bowl. He's doing a backsmith I kind of always wanted to shoot a photo from inside the bowl and get like a natural curve, and kind of just worked out that Shugen had the plane going over as well, and that just worked out because there's this massive plane and just the sun had come through where it did. And it's funny because it's the easiest photo I've probably ever shot. So I guess when you start, like, I'm always looking at other people's photos. And you're like, oh, I really like this person's, I really like that. And as you start taking on other people's stuff throughout the time, you end up, you don't realize it, but then you end up having your own style and you go, oh, I really like this and I'm going to shoot it this way, as opposed to someone else will come and shoot it a different way. So why skateboarding stands out to me, it's so different, it's unique. Like, I'm not going to have the same style as one of my mates. It's the same with photography. I hate to say, like, oh, it's an art, like, it's an, like, an art thing, but it really is when you think about it. Like, sounds corny, but it really is, like, the way that people look at things, I guess. But